So yes, guys, today, as the title suggests, we are stacking up two strings against each other. Lux Salon, ALU Power, an established brand we all know and love. Used on tour by the likes of Monfils, Murray, Opelka, and even two of the GOATs, Federer and Djokovic, at least in hybrid setups. But on my right, new to the scene, an underdog, OEHMS, ALU Pearl, used by the likes of the California Condor, aspiring ATP player. Can this bad boy pack a punch above his weight class, perhaps dethrone ALU Power for a fraction of the price? Might want to consider it. Today we find out with the help of Evoke Tennis. Without further ado, let's bring him up. Yes, guys, there you have it. Clearly a chasm between the two string setups of Evoke Tennis, the string guru, and yours truly, a humble California Condor. But what matters is the tennis on court, baby. So before I show footage from this session revealing ALU Power, let's go back 2 weeks ago and show the footage from ALU Pearl, again with Vacation Tennis. Let's do it.
Before you go any further, check out the link for Evoke Tennis. Unbelievable knowledge when it comes to all things strings in the description below. But for now, let's listen to what he has to say.
Initial thoughts, string guru, on OEHMS ALU Pearl.
I liked it. It's a very spinny string. So I'd heard it was a knockoff of ALU Power, but a couple things. So this is OEHMS Pearl Rough, right?
Yes.
Texture. ALU Power, hold up. ALU Power Rough is a textured string. And so this is a shaped string. It's not a textured string from what I am seeing, okay? But from what I saw on the website as well, it is a eight-sided string. Mm. So I would put it more closer, as, if you're talking about knockoff, it would have to be a knockoff of ALU Power Spin, which is a five-sided version of ALU Power. I'm not saying that those are the same thing, but when I was stringing it up, had less coil memory than ALU Power. It's not as shiny and sort of gummy feeling as ALU Power. ALU Power kind of just has like a little bit of a rubbery type, plasticky rubbery type feel. This, you know, you can feel the edges in your fingers. And so just a little bit different. Now, my initial impressions, it's like a tour bite. And it has a crispness to it.
Mm.
It has a ton of spin, so I was like dropping them short. Trying to figure out how, like, I was trying to like artificially get spin, but you don't have to with this. I really liked the string. It was a nice, I've been playing tennis that much in the winter. So it was a nice, like, I started up at 43 pounds, just a couple pounds less than I normally would. Still had a crispness to it. Traditionally, a rough string is a textured string, it's a dimpled string.
Right.
And ALU Power Rough is, you know, obviously known for that. Now, it's a made in Germany string, so maybe it's just a translation. They're calling it rough. Is it rough in your fingers when you touch it? Yes. It's just a shaped string. So,
All right, so probably a rhetorical question, but if you had to be sponsored by ALU Power or ALU Pearl, who would you sign with?
I like how Lux Salon, they seem like they're always coming out with new stuff.
Right.
They're always doing something. But I don't know anything really about this company, but I also do support the smaller guys too. So I'm sure it's super hard to get a string off. And like, this is super cheap, right?
Unbelievably cheap. Like 55 bucks for a reel, which will afford you 16 rackets strong. So I mean, I believe that's less than $4 a string, but I'll have to calculate at a different time.
Fell off the back of a Lux Salon truck. Repackaged, possibly, I don't know.
You never know.
I had six rackets come in yesterday and they wanted ALU Power, but I was out of it. He had given me this reel to try and I was staring down this going, I might have ALU Power.
I would not have held it against you had you gone down that road.
I didn't do it, we found another option, but anyway, I'm thinking it's a tour bite, just that aggressive shaped string, not a beginner string, cool. You know.
Well, I look forward to seeing your thoughts on tension maintenance as you play with it more, and maybe some more thoughts
down the road if any come to you as you keep playing with it.
ALU Power, baby. The one and only.
Let's go. All right, what are your final words then regarding ALU Power versus ALU Pearl? I know it wasn't the most extensive review, but to me, they're nothing alike. if the name, you know, implies that, I don't think they're anything alike.
But they're both gray, they're both polys, they must play the same.
Right. The ALU Power to me is kind of softer actually in the beginning of its life. And a little bit shinier and just round and kind of comfortable, and it's a power string, whereas ALU Pearl Rough was like dead.
Yeah.
Low power, very aggressive, sharp, big swinging type of player. Yeah,
that's right. There isn't much zing back out of the swing bed. So yep. Dead, quote you.
During the winter, it's tough for me to get the racket speed that you need. I think in the summer, like, this could be like awesome. I mean, a cheap poly that like anybody could kind of pick up and just string like frequently.
What about spin potential? Which do you give the nod to?
So like if you want that crazy feel of spin, extra spin and grip, ALU Pearl Rough's gonna have that. You're gonna have to do a little bit, oh gosh, it's hard to say. Like. People like ALU Power because of the power and the kind of feel it has. So it's not known as like a crazy spin string. However, the pros play with it and you can get crazy spin off of it, right, with your swing. And you get crazy spin off of ALU Pearl Rough as well. It's just you're going to have to really, really work for it, you know, with a good swing speed.
Yeah.
So.
All right, well, as always, thank you for the expertise. Thank you for the court time.
No problem.
All right, I'll see you guys back in my living room for my final thoughts. So what can I say, folks? I have to echo the sentiment shared by Evoke Tennis just moments ago. Initially, what meets the eye is carbon copies of each other, ALU Pearl copying ALU Power, but they're not all that similar. Again, one of them, shape string, emphasis on spin potential, and much less lively, deader, stiffer. ALU Power, on the other hand, takes the inertia, the energy from the ball, spits it right back into it as it leaves your string bed. So much more power to be found in ALU Power. Surprise, surprise. It's not a bad thing. They're just different, and different strokes for different folks. So if you want, again, a little bit more control, a little bit less responsive feel, but more spin, Pearl might be the way to go, especially considering the value that it brings, the bang for the buck, so to speak, $395 compared to $1995. I'm sorry, but I'm just not making money. It does not grow on trees, and my tennis, I hate to say it, is on a bit of a budget, so I am hard-pressed to spend $1995 on one string bed when I can get, again, perfectly viable string. It plays differently. It's not a bad thing. It's just different. For $395. So that's my findings, and I will stick with it. Subscribe to the channel, trying to grow it, and remember that a trashman tennis, it's all about the tennis trash we've been.